Hi, I'm Jon SIskel. I'm the co-director of Louder Than a Bomb, and my co-director, Greg Jacobs, was actually the one who found and discovered our subject matter. He was driving on the north side of Chicago on a Saturday night and saw this alternative rock club, the Metro, and it said on the marquee, Louder Than a Bomb Youth Poetry Slam, and saw all these kids, hundreds of kids, lined up around the block for poetry on a Saturday night. And so Monday he came into the office and said, you know, we should check this out. And once we met Kevin Koval, the founder of Louder Than a Bomb, and we went and saw our first slam, it really was the electricity on stage and that interaction between the poet on stage and the audience that really captivated us and propelled us into making the film, our documentary, Louder Than a Bomb. You know, the slam poetry movement, definitely rap and hip-hop are a major influence, but, you know, the teachers in the Chicago public high schools and, you know, public school teachers all over the country use, you know, poets from, you know, all the major poets, Langston Hughes and Gwendolyn Brooks, E. Cummings, people like that, are just as much an influence, but hip-hop definitely is a strong current through the slam movement. For young people today, the slam movement and slam poetry is a great entry point into poetry, all forms of poetry. So yeah, it's definitely reaching a different younger audience. So we follow four teams of poets in Chicago, four high school teams. And one is from Steinmetz High School, and the Steinmetzites, as they're known by, were the winners of Louder Than a Bomb the previous year to when we started filming. And they really are wrestling with that success and just how to, you know, repeat and really how to find their sense of where they belong in this community of slam poets in Chicago. Then we have from Whitney Young, Nate Marshall, who is just an incredible poet, really has been doing it since he, as he says, since he was three. His teacher refers to him as the grandfather of poetry slam, and he's just an incredible talent, and a lot of his music is actually in the film as well. From Oak Park River Forest High School, we have Novana Venerable, who is also just an amazing poet. She's a very kind of tough, steely kid who doesn't let her emotions shine through, but through her poetry really is able to kind of uses the poetry as therapy in a way. So, and then we finally have Adam Gottlieb from Northside College Prep. And Adam is, as some people have referred to him, as an Allen Ginsberg of this community. He's just an incredible talent and, you know, just a real shining light in the slam community. I think it can be so many things for all of these kids. It gives, most importantly, I think it gives them an outlet to tell their stories. It gives them a platform to talk to their peers, talk to their families, talk to their coaches, and talk to the, you know, wider community about the stuff that's going on in their lives. I think young people today, you know, have a lot to offer and a lot of stories to tell, and this is, slam is a great platform for them.